Hello everyone, my name is Megha Varman and my metric number is 193499. So first, let me give a basic information about heat conduction. Heat conduction describes the distribution of heat in a given region over time. The heat conduction of heat of a material depends on both space and also time. For example, when a metal bar is heated, there will be distribution of heat as the heat spreads throughout the space. If we take U as the for temperature, the rate of change of U is proportional to the curvature of U. So let me draw a graph describing this phenomenon. So this is a y-axis and we take it as temperature or U, and this one is for a time x-axis time. So the graph roughly will look like this. So when we heat a metal bar over this region, there will be increase in temperature in this region. You guys can see. But there's a sudden drop in this temperature. This is due to the distribution of heat to the other regions. So we are heating this region. After this region is getting sufficient heat, it will be distributed to the other regions of the metal bar. So let me continue with the basic equation of the 1D heat conduction equation. So this is a basic equation for the 1D heat conduction equation.
Hello, my name is Mama Arif Hakimi Bimama Yusri. My metric number is 193473. So today, me and my friends are going to show you how to solve the problem given. So this is the equation. Since this is heat conduction problem, it will show the sine and cos graph. So we will use Vx equal to sine k lambda t and Vx equal to sine k, sorry, cos lambda t. By substituting the Vx in our equation, we will have four possible equations, which is
U1 sine lambda x sine k lambda t, U2 cos k lambda t.
Our four possible solution. So in order to know which is satisfy the equation, we need to substitute the value when x is equal to 0, and we will have this one. So after substituting the value of x equal to 0, we will obtain only two equations, which is U1 and U3 equal to 0. So I will pass my explanation to my friends. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Haziq bin Muhammad Zaki. My metric number 1925-98. Okay, so thank you for Chip for presenting just now. Okay, so now we'll continue what Chip has explained. We will now use the second condition. Okay, from the first condition, we know that U1, U3 is the one that satisfies the first condition. So now we will move to second condition where at U0, where U, x equal to 1, x will equal to 1, and t will equal to 0. Okay, so this is the condition. Now, we know that sine lambda from the condition will equal to 0. So we know that lambda will equal to 0, right? So, from this, we will see the graph for sine, for the sine graph. So from the sine graph, we know that sine will begin from 0. And then move downward and upward and downward. So from this we know that 0 is at the pi. This one is 2 pi and this one is 3 pi. So now we know that lambda will actually equal to 0 and then pi and then 2 pi and so on. Okay? So from this we know that the U1 and U3 is both U sine. So if we substitute the value for pi, 2 pi, 3 pi for lambda, we will get sine will equal to 0. So U1 will equal to 0 and U3 will also equal to 0. So U1 and U3 both satisfy the second condition. Thank you.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning. My name is Amirul Bimadini and my metric number is 192305. Okay, from the previous explanation from Aziz, we get the equation U1 and U3, the lambda. Right, so next I will explain the condition is this condition. So we differentiate this to get the answer. The dudx is cos, sine to cos, and we substitute the t is equal to 0, and we get the dudx for the u1 is 0, so it's satisfied for this condition. And next we check the U3, we differentiate the equation, so we get the sine to cos and we substitute the at t equal to 0 and we get the answer is this. So this is not equal to 0, so this is not satisfied to this condition. So that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Amir Mustaqim bin Nazar. My metric number is 193249. Okay, let me continue for the last part of this question. So the final condition that the question given is u equal to this. So from the my previous friend have told about the equation that satisfies the condition is U3, which is this. So we just compare the U3 with the condition that the question had given. Okay. First, we need to change the sine into cos. So I change just. I use a trigonometry identity and just change it. For the end, we can just ignore because it's just a constant. Pi x. K I t. Okay, for the next step is I just use to put the V1. Pi over 2. And then plus with B2 cos pi x. Okay. For the next step is I substitute t equal to 0 in this equation. So we can get V1 cos pi over 2x. This becomes 0, cos 0 is 1,
plus V2 pi x is also equal to 1 because cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay, for the next step, we just compare this equation with the condition that given. So we can get V1 equal to A and V2 equal to 1. So we just substitute V1 and V2 into the question. U equal to A cos pi over 2x cos k pi t plus B2 equal to 1, so we can get cos pi x cos k pi t. So this is the answer, last answer.